I am the dragon. I inhabit the northwest of the world. My sleep and waking determine night and day. My breathing regulates the seasons and the wind. I am the dragon. I came from the center of the earth to surface in this West Coast village, a place near the crossroads of two continents, Asia and North America. I saw people gathering in the village meadow. A giant kite was being prepared for flight. It looked like the West Coast dragon, Susilo, who has no beginning, has no end. Guardian spirits circled the meadow, images anchored in the civilizations of the past. The children helped to launch the giant kite made in my image. They were sending it to China, a Western delegate, to a kite festival in honor of my year, the year of the dragon. I decided to accompany the dragon kite on its journey to China. I try to visit the land of the dragon on every one of my 12-year cycles. I was curious to see if the people in China would recognize the Western dragon, if not as one of their own, at least as a relative. The feeling of the wind carrying me into the sky. I can get a bird's eye view of the ground below. One can see so much more. After we passed the cedar guardians of the North Pacific coast, we headed west. Below me, sparkling like a string of pearls, lay the chain of islands, the Aleutians, that once were part of the land bridge connecting Asia to North America. We arrived in Beijing after the last snowfall of the winter season.
Once again, Beijing will be clear with temperature ranging between 10 and 23. That's our weather report.
My crew had made arrangements to visit the Forbidden City.
At the gate of this hotel, we should meet 8:30.
This is the heart of the land of the dragon. A place history has painted magenta and gold, the colors of emperors of the past. Still the giant birds are there, supernatural animal spirits guarding the palace day and night. They watch over a young musician who plays ancient melodies on the pipa, an instrument that came to China from Persia more than 1,000 years ago. A 1,000 years which are, to me, like a drop of water in the lake of eternity. Dong Pu Fong says, spring is here. Historically, this has always been the time of year in China when people were drawn together, hoping ideas would blossom to bring about change for a better future. In the past, it was Emperor Qin Shi Huang who built the Great Wall. In this time, Chairman Mao's words still linger in the lives of the people.
Serve the people. September the 8th, 1944. And all people in the revolutionary ranks must care for each other, must love and help each other.
On Tiananmen Square, a soldier was flying a kite, a common pastime for many of the people in the land of the dragon. My crew decided to fly the dragon kite here. The kite was too big. There were far too many people in the square.
If we have shortcomings, we're not afraid to have them pointed out and criticized.
The Western Dragon Kite had been entered to fly in the annual International Kite Competition in Weifang, a city of 8 million people in Shandong Province.
What is this? This is a pen.
Weifang is a city near the North China Sea, the kite capital of the world. Spaces between people are narrowing in the land of the dragon. The old people, who have seen so many changes, are still islands in a human sea of constant ebb and flow.
Ha ha ha!
A long time ago, the dragon people chiseled words into stone. Their memory is not like mine. This young woman is taking a print of words by a writer from the past.
The ancient Chinese writer Sima Qian said, "Though death befalls all men alike, it may be weightier than Mount Tai or lighter than a feather."
In China, calligraphy is an art form as much as it is communication. Tian, the word for sky.
Sky.
Fei, the character for the word fly. My friend Phoenix is a frequent sight in China skies. Many of the townspeople were in the dried-out riverbed that afternoon, flying kites. It hadn't rained for 8 years. I knew this was going to change. It always rains in the year of the dragon. The river would come back in the future.
Yes, the main subject.
The main subject.
Yes.
Kites. The crew were learning to fly kites from the dragon people. They needed instruction, as was apparent from their attempt at Tiananmen Square. We visited an old kite maker at Yangjiabu. All his life he had lived in this village where everyone made kites and flew them for pleasure in the afternoons. His father had made a phoenix for the emperor's court in Beijing. The family now specializes in the making of dragon kites.
The old man looked at me and said, "I know you." I held his hand as we walked back to his house. Later on, he looked at me again and said, "Perhaps I don't know you." I smiled at him and said, "We know each other through our dreams."
I joined the old man's dragon kite in the sky. We traveled to the kite field together.
What we have to do is we have to move the kite.
Well, they have their gloves on. April 2nd, 1988. This is the competition flight. The crew were now half and half, three from the North American West Coast, three from China.
It felt good to know so many young hands were preparing the kite for his first flight in China the next day.
Yeah.
He said the string is shorter, the higher, and the lower.
Is it true? I know nothing about kite flying.
Oh no, why? Let's try.
I mean, this is the first time
I've seen something like that.
Yes, like this. One more.
The Western Dragon Kite and I were on our way to the dance celebration in the sky. We passed Lone Star from Germany. Centipede had come from Colorado. And Giselle from France. Cobra from Thailand intimidated some of the smaller kites. Winged parafoil from Italy. This ribbon kite is the Australian representative. This is my friend from the village of Yongjiaobu. He was made from bamboo and hand-painted silk.
I think it's time. It's 1 o'clock. He said we'll be late for the ceremony.
Yeah.
He says it's really time.
The procession started with my color, red, the color of the dragon's heart. This is the symbol for the city of Weifang. It is an abstraction of the dragon's head.
Thank you.
Oh, yes. The Chinese people recognize the Western dragon image. They awarded it the prize for one of the 10 unique kites in the world. I think I shall come back next time. These children are the future of China. They wished us well for our return journey as we were heading east across the Pacific Ocean. I am taking their laughter with me in my heart. North American coast, there are other children flying kite birds in the sky. The children come from many lands in this city. Not all of them know that just north of here is the land of the eagle. The West Coast dragon and ancient cedar carvings tell the story of the history of the land, a land now separated from Asia by the Pacific Ocean. We passed the three watchmen on our way to the welcome feast for the dragon kite's return. I am the dragon. I inhabit the northwest of the world. My sleep and waking determine night and day. My breathing regulates the seasons and the wind. It is time for me to return to the center of the earth. What will I find in the next century when I join the people for another celebration in my honor? At 2,000 years, human time.
We must not lose sight of our achievements, must see the bright future, and must pluck up our courage.